हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सीएनसी एंड एनसी मशीन्स, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ सीएनसी मशीन। ऑल दिस थिंग्स वी हैव टू सी इन दिस टुडे सेशन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टू दिस सेशन आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल, क्लिक ऑन बेल आइकॉन टू गेट मोर नोटिफिकेशन। If you see in the conventional NC system, the entire data input and data handling sequences are including control functions are determined only by the fixed circuit interconnections of decision elements and storage elements. So if any modification in part requires a preparation of new tape, so NC system is a hardwired or rigid system. So what are the elements of NC system that we have seen in previous lecture? If you want to see, the link is in description box, or you can see in the suggestion link. So to overcome the problems which are occurred in NC machines, the CNC machines were introduced in 70s due to the involvement of a computer. They are capable of performing a large number of functions. The commands to the machines are essentially through a floppy disk or hard disk with the help of appropriate computer language programming. So computers are having a distinct advantages of memory storage. Hence, a simple command for a change of a stored program can start immediately producing a different types of component. So these are the some very good advantages of CNC machine that we are now, if you visit any industry, they are replaced the conventional machines with this CNC. So in today's session we are going to see the difference between NC machines and CNC machines. So NC machine is a numerical control machines where these machines is not controlled by computer, but CNC machines are controlled by computer. The program is fed to the computer with a programmable language that alphanumeric data, alphabets and numbers are provided. In this NC machine, the input given through punch tape that we have seen in previous lecture, the punch tape, based on that punch tape, the input is given. In CNC machine, input is given directly through computer. So if you, whatever the inputs, the direction of the axis and spindle speed, feed rate, how the part tool is moved or tool change, all these systems or input is given through the computer. So the layout of the screen you can see, and based on that we can change any input data. In NC machines, the tape reading, whatever the tape reading is done at a remote place. But in CNC machine, the reading and editing we can do at machine site itself. So here you can see, based on the machine editing we can do here also. This NC machine, the reliability is less. CNC machine is giving more reliability. We cannot change the program. If you want to change the program, again you have to design the punch tape. Then we have to record that punch tape and give the machine control unit. Then program to it is very difficult. So program editing is not possible in NC machine. We can easily edit the program based on the part design. We can change based on programmable data, and we can provide that programmable data to the MCU based on the part program, and we can do the operations. NC machine, we are not simulating the part program, it is not possible. But CNC machine, the part program simulation is possible. You can see the simulation of turning process, how the process is going to happen, that we can see in this CNC machine. NC machines, we are not storing the part program. But in CNC machine, use of the computer, which having a very good advantages of memory, we can store the part program and we can change, edit the part program easily by using CNC machine, by using a computer. CNC machines are less flexible. CNC machines are highly flexible because of the storing of the part program, reading, editing of the part program. CNC machines are less capable, and CNC machines are having higher capability. So these are the difference between CNC machines and CNC machine. Now we are going to focus upon this CNC machine. For that, we are going to see first the classification of CNC machine. First, it is classified based on the motion type, that is point-to-point control system and contouring system, that continuous path. Based on that, it is classified. Second, it is classified based on the control loop, that is open loop system and closed loop system, where the feedback is important. So in closed loop system, the feedback devices are used. Based on the power supply, how the power supply is given to the CNC machine, they are classified based on the hydraulic, pneumatic and electrical. Also, we can classify based on the axis, that is 2 and 3 axis CNC machines or higher axis CNC machines also. Now we are going to see the components of CNC machine. First one is the input device, where we are providing a part programs. So the part program is a combination of alphabets and numericals. Hence the data fed and contained at this program is called as alphanumeric data. So the programs are given to the CNC are again divided into three types. First one is a part program, where it has a part dimensions, spindle speed and feed rate is given. Second, service program, that used to check, edit, correct the part program. And third is a control program. It accepts the part program as a input data to produce signals to drive the axis of motion. So these are the part program is given to the MCU. So MCU is a computer that stores the part program and converts it to the desired commands for the machine tool. The machine tool carry servo motors or stepper motors to execute the commands. This MCU consists of two parts. One part is known as DPU, that is data processing unit, and the other is known as CLU, that is control loop unit. So in DPU includes control software, analytical software, translation software for the basic purposes. It further consists of interpolation software for achieving multidirectional contoured motion of tool head or workpiece to be as smooth as possible. Then other part is a control loop unit. It is responsible for operating various drives, receiving feedback from the result, under achievement and monitoring the same. So this MCU gives the signal through pulses for executing the different types of motion by the respective motors. So these motions are transferred to the driving system, where servo motors or stepper motors act, and the feed rate and spindle speed are given. Also, miscellaneous functions, that is machine tool, how the machine tool moved from one place to the another place based on the part drawing. Also, we can change the tools which required for performing the specific operation for the tool turret. So these can be get the information from the MCU. Then the feedback system. The CNC is having a feedback system where we are getting the feedback of the position. Also the velocity feedback is given. Here we are using the programmable logic controller, where it receives the feedback signal about actual movement of the machine tool through feedback devices. Feedback devices are transducers and encoders. These feedback signals are compared with the input signal and error correction is done. So again it is transferred to the machine control unit. If any changes we want to do, then we can change and we can set the motion data and miscellaneous function to the driving system and machine tool. And all these we can see on the display unit, where how the part is programmed one line by line, that we can see if any malfunction is ring out or any function not functioning the proper output, then we can change. So we can see that on the display unit. So these are the components of a CNC system. Also, it is CNC is having some features like storage more than one part program. It is having various forms of program input, program editing at machine tool, it can be possible. It is having a good interpolation, that helical, parabolic or cubic interpolation are executed through CNC. Combination interfaces, that machine can be linked to other computers and computer driven devices like robots. If you visit any industry, there the robots are used and the programs are given based on the CNC machines. It is having a diagnostics, like online diagnostics capability to detect malfunctions or system breakdowns can be done in this CNC machine. So based on these features, the CNC machine having advantages, like it is now, if we are using the CNC, that is computer numerical control, we are reducing the lead time, then elimination of operator error. The operator which is performing the operation on conventional machining, that operator error can be reduced by using CNC machine. Here the operator is used only to check any display unit, also to loading and unloading of a job. Then it lowers the labor cost. If we are using conventional machining, then we require to produce a good job the skill worker, so that skill worker is might be getting a good amount of money, so that labor cost can be reduced. Also the part which are getting, that has good quality of dimensions and surface finish, so the quality functions can be reduced. Then it is having a longer tool life, that we are using optimum cutting speed, feed and depth of cut. Elimination of special jigs and features. Flexibility in change of component design. Reduce inspection. Less scrap can be produced. Accurate costing and scheduling. So these are the good advantages of CNC machine. Either it is having some disadvantages, like higher investment cost. If you seen based on these disadvantages, in conventional machining, to produce a part, number of parts of an identical size, we required a skilled worker, and that skilled worker will produce the part. So we can't say that the one part which is manufactured or 10 parts which is manufactured, it will be having the same quality and same dimensions. So that will be difficult. But in CNC machine, whatever the parts which are manufactured, for one part, 10 part or 100 or 1000 parts, will get the same dimensional accuracy and same quality. So there, if you consider that the output and productivity, then to bear that investment cost can be very easily. So now all the conventional machining in industry are replaced by VMC and HMC, that vertical milling center and horizontal milling center, all these are changed. So every industrial person is doing that investment. Then higher maintenance cost. So maintenance cost is higher based on the breakdowns of drive systems or breakdowns of tool. So there is a higher maintenance cost. Costlier CNC personnel. The personnel is operating that CNC, that will be costly. He has to check display unit regularly to any other change in the feedback system or system breakdowns or any malfunctions. We have to plan support facility to this CNC. That CNC machine should be planned where it should be kept in a very good area, so that support facility is required. So these are the disadvantages. So here In this session, we have seen the difference between CNC and NC machine, the classification of CNC machine, why the CNC machines are used, what are the features of CNC machines, then components of CNC machines, advantages, disadvantages of CNC machines, and you can see any nearby industry they are using this CNC machine. So if you like this video, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Click on bell icon to get more notifications. If you want to cover any topic regarding engineering background for the mechanical stream or any other stream, please put that topic name in comment box. Thank you. Thank you very much.